Papal Timeline Fast Facts. Here's some background information about the Vatican's timetable and process for choosing a new pope. Approximate timetable. This timeline is based on 1996 Pope John Paul II's constitution on the conclave, Universi Dominici Gregis, and on what by has happened in previous conclaves. Burial and mourning upon death of a pope. Cardinals decide, after the death of the pope, when funerals in conclave begin. Universi Dominici Gregis, hereafter referred to as law, dictates that there must be 9 days of mourning. The conclave cannot begin earlier than 15 days, and no later than 20 days after the pope's death. The pope has to be buried between the 4th and 6th day after death. The embalmed body of the pope has to be on display at St. Peter's Basilica for mourning. Choosing a new pope based on the above and what traditionally happens after the pope dies, we can assume the following timetable. Day ONEBy tradition and law, Vatican Radio announces the pope's death. Sedes Vacantes. Sedes Vacantes. The seat of the Holy See is empty, and it is referred to the death of the pope. The interregnum begins. Cardinals start gathering in Rome. Interregnum. The period between the death of pope and the election of a new pope. Day ONEBy tradition, the body of the pope is dressed in papal vestments and will be put on display at St. Peter's Basilica. Pilgrims will flock St. Peter's. Mourning begins and by law must continue for 9 days, novendiales, ending on the 10th day after death. There will be a mass on each day. Novendiales. 9 days of mourning. Day 4, 5 or 6 by law, a burial takes place. Tradition calls for popes to be buried in St. Peter's Basilica. Day 10 by tradition, big funeral mass takes place at St. Peter's. Day 15, earliest possible date, by law, conclave begins in the Sistine Chapel. On that morning, the cardinals will concelebrate the votive mass pro eligendo papa. The cardinals will determine where to hold the mass, most likely it will be in St. Peter's Basilica. In the afternoon they will start the conclave. In theory they can vote that afternoon. The voting the cardinals will vote twice in the morning and twice in the afternoon. At the end of each voting session, they will burn the ballots and send a signal to the world by the color of the smoke. Black for no pope and white for pope. For the first time, pealing bells from St. Peter's will accompany the white smoke, so that there is no confusion. Voting can go on for days. Read. Selecting a pope. After the new pope is elected, he will come out St. Peter's Basilica main balcony. A cardinal will say the words Habemus Papa, and will announce the new pope's name. By tradition, anywhere between 30 minutes to 1 hour can pass between the white smoke and the appearance on the balcony. It is only when the cardinal announces the name that we'll know who he is. Inauguration of the new pope will likely take place days after his election. He decides where and when to hold the mass, although it probably will be at St. Peter's. Pope Francis waves from the top of the steps as he prepares to depart Philadelphia International Airport on Sunday, September 27, on his way back to Rome. The pope has been on a 6-day visit to the United States, with stops in Washington, New York and Philadelphia. Pope Francis greets families at the conclusion of Mass at the World Meeting of Families at Benjamin Franklin Parkway in Philadelphia on September 27. A huge crowd gathers to celebrate Mass with Pope Francis on September 27 in Philadelphia. Pope Francis celebrates Mass at the World Meeting of Families at Benjamin Franklin Parkway in Philadelphia on September 27. Pope Francis waves to the crowd from the Popemobile during a parade along the Benjamin Franklin Parkway before Mass on September 27 in Philadelphia. Pope Francis waves to the audience as he leaves St. Charles Borromeo Seminary in Wynwood, Pennsylvania, after addressing bishops on September 27. Aretha Franklin performs as Pope Francis looks on during the Festival of Families on September 26 in Philadelphia. Pope Francis takes the stage at the Festival of Families on September 26 in Philadelphia. Pope Francis speaks in front of Independence Hall, from the lectern used by President Abraham Lincoln during the Gettysburg Address, on Saturday, September 26, in Philadelphia. Pope Francis rides in the Popemobile along Independence Mall before delivering a speech outside Independence Hall on September 26. Residents in decorated apartment windows await the arrival of Pope Francis near Independence Mall on September 26. Pope Francis blesses communion during a Mass at Cathedral Basilica of Saints Peter and Paul, Saturday, September 26, in Philadelphia. Pope Francis delivers Mass before a crowd of more than 2,000, consisting largely of priests, women religious and deacons on September 26. Members of the choir arrive at Cathedral Basilica of Saints Peter and Paul prior to the arrival of Pope Francis on September 26. Pope Francis kisses and blesses Michael Keating, 10, of Elverson, Pennsylvania, after arriving in Philadelphia on September 26. Keating has cerebral palsy and is the son of Chuck Keating, director of the Bishop Shenahan High School Band, which performed at Pope Francis's airport arrival. The faithful receive communion at the snack bar during Mass at Madison Square Garden on September 25. Pope Francis celebrates Mass at Madison Square Garden on Friday, September 25, in New York City. A crucifix hangs above members of the clergy during Mass at Madison Square Garden on September 25. Pope Francis rides through New York Central Park on September 25. Francis addressed the UN General Assembly and will head to Philadelphia this weekend for the World Meeting of Families, a large Catholic event expected to draw nearly 1 million pilgrims. Pope Francis greets the crowd in New York's East Harlem neighborhood on September 25. Pope Francis places a white rose at the 9/11 memorial in New York on September 25. Francis attends a multi-religious service at the 9/11 memorial. The Pope arrives at the UN General Assembly to give his speech. Francis gives a thumbs up after leading an evening prayer service Thursday, September 24, at St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York. Nuns celebrate at St. Patrick's Cathedral as they wait for the arrival of Pope Francis. Francis greets crowds as he arrives at St. Patrick's Cathedral. Crowds welcome Pope Francis to New York on September 24 after his arrival at John F. Kennedy International Airport. A Pope Francis doll amuses the man himself at John F. Kennedy International Airport. Pope Francis stops to look at a sculpture of Spanish-born missionary Junipero Serra at the U.S. Capitol in Washington on September 24. The Pope canonized Serra during a Mass the day before. Members of Congress accompany Pope Francis on the Speaker's balcony on Capitol Hill on September 24. Congressional staffers and guests strain to view and photograph the Pope at the Capitol. Francis blesses a child at the Capitol. Pope Francis addresses a joint meeting of the U.S. Congress on September 24. Vice President Joe Biden and House Speaker John Boehner sit behind him in the House chamber. Francis is the first pope to address a joint meeting of Congress. Boehner welcomes Pope Francis before his speech to Congress. Pope Francis canonizes Serra during a Mass in Washington on Wednesday, September 23. The Pope celebrates Mass at the National Shrine of the Immaculate Conception on September 23. Nuns wait for Pope Francis to arrive inside the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Immaculate Conception. Pope Francis greets crowds during his parade in Washington on September 23. Pope Francis reaches out to bless a child during the parade in Washington. President Barack Obama hosts the Pope in the Oval Office of the White House on September 23. Obama, the Pope and First Lady Michelle Obama greet the crowd during an arrival ceremony on the South Lawn of the White House on September 23. Pope Francis addresses guests on the South Lawn of the White House. People wave U.S. and Vatican flags as they wait for the Pope's arrival at the White House on September 23. Early on September 23, people gather along Pope Francis's parade route in Washington. Pope Francis departs from Andrews Air Force Base in Maryland shortly after his flight landed on Tuesday, September 22. Pope Francis waves from his car at Andrews Air Force Base. Pope Francis is escorted by the Obamas and their daughters after arriving in the country. Clergy members brace for the wind as they stand on the tarmac at Andrews Air Force Base. The Pope waves at Obama and his family. Click subscribe to receive the latest news.